الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. عن أبي ذر جندب بن جنادة رضي الله عنه The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم قال اتق الله حيثما كنت وأتبع السيئة الحسنة تمحها وخالق الناس بخلق حسن. سبحان الله. This advice from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, narrated by amazing Sahaba Abu Dharr and Mu'adh ibn Jabal also narrate this hadith. You know, if you hear the hadith, I want you to imagine somebody speaks in a microphone. You know, in the big loudspeakers, and how the wave travel and keeps going till somebody very far away, they can hardly hear it. Yeah? But in the old days, they didn't have microphone. Before electricities, before microphone, they had human being repeating what the speaker is saying. It's called the repeater. You know, nowadays when the electricity goes off, you hear people in the salah. When they have, like in our country's big masjid, and people outside the masjid, they don't know what's going on inside when the mic stops. Yeah? So somebody have to be visible and seeing, and he will say, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدًا. The person saying, رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدُ. Everybody knows that. In Mecca and Medina, that's what they do all the time. Now they do that. Oh, yeah? So in old days, it's a repeater. Repeat what the Prophet ﷺ will say when the crowds is too many. But now the Sahaba radiallahu anhum did not just stop in Medina as a repeater. They took the message across the oceans, across the continent, across the sea, and they're repeating the message. And then the Sahaba passed it on to the children, and the children, and the children, all the way to Al-Ameen Masjid in Wellington, New Zealand, 2020, and we're repeating the same thing. It will continue. This is that's what they call a chain. You know the chain, human chain? This is a human chain. Every time we read a hadith, we're holding a chain to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's a huge honor for us. It's a massive honor to be sitting and listening to what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. He says, اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتْ. His advice, three advice. Be conscious of Allah wherever you are. Whatever the situation is, just think about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expects of you. Don't worry about what people will say if I don't play with them this game. What people will say if I don't know this song. What people, don't worry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is number one in your list. And Allah will give you the joy and the happiness and the protection and the peace and whatever human being desire. اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتْ. Wherever you are. You know shaitan tells us what? In the masjid. You know, you have taqwa of Allah when you pray. After that, no taqwa. No. The believers, taqwa of Allah all the time. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from them. And the second one, you're not perfect. You're not going to have taqwa 24/7. It's impossible for a human being. You're not angels. Only angels do that. Human being, you will forget salah. You will forget rukuh. You will forget lots of things. You will eat sometime, you know, in the wrong things. Yeah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when you make a mistake, watba' al-sayyi'a al-hasana. Remember and say, oh Allah, please forgive me. I'm sorry. Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. And make a good deed. It's not astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah with your tongue. No. It has to be action. What is action? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the best action to make some other people happy. What the Prophet Musa did, when Prophet Musa والسلام, was running away from the army of Fir'aun, they're going to kill him, running away, no food, no clothes, no money, nothing, no family, no house, no nothing. The first thing he did, he helped the poor ladies. The first thing he did, he helped the poor ladies to feed the animals and get the water for them. The help came from Allah. Help other people. When you make a mistake, come and vacuum the masjid. Come and clean the toilet. Come and sweep outside. Come and carry the rubbish. At home, just clean the toilet at home. Vacuum the house. Get the washing. Tidy the rubbish. Whatever it is, as a good deed. Not just astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَعْمَلُوا أَلَى دَوُودَ شُكْرًا. You need to show in action that you are grateful and believer. You don't just say, astaghfirullah al-azim. Oh Allah, please forgive me. And enough. No. The action. All the sahaba says, Umar ibn al-Khattab, when he tell the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why we signed this agreement, it's not fair for us. He says, فَعَمِلْتُ لَهَا عَمَالًا. I keep on doing good deed all the rest of my life because of this tiny argument with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, وَاتْبَعِ السَّيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُهَا. Follow the bad deed, follow the mistake with a good deed. It will wipe it out. It will wipe it out. And the third one, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَخَالِقِ النَّاسِ بِخُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ. When you deal with people, just show a good character. Show a good character, because the first two is between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But also between you and the people have rights on you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us good akhlaq, good manners, good values. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us respect each other and help each other. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us reason for happiness, reason for success wherever we are. We ask Allah to bless us and our family, to protect us and our family, and to help the ummah of Muhammad wherever they are. وآخر دعوان الحمد لله رب العالمين وجزاكم الله خيرا.